you're a soldier. I'm asking you to give me your name, your rank, and your number, and you need to do that.
Something's moving down at the end there, but it's behind the laser grid and the static cam.
My name's Jeff. This is Clive. The man with the camera is Phil. What's your name?
It's like someone standing behind there watching us.
Take over now.
What the f***?
Yes, sir, yes.
I've been poisoned.
Dead Man's Island, also known as the Detached Bastion. Towards the end of the 18th century, England was at war with America and her allies, France, Spain, and the Netherlands, in the American War of Independence. At the time, there was a large army amassed on the other side of the channel ready to invade. This forced the building of massive defense works around Dover. These were to supplement the aging medieval castles, so large forts were constructed on the western heights. The bastion was constructed to provide a defensive line between the two main forts in Dover, the citadel and the redoubt. Construction work began in 1804 during the Napoleonic Wars, but the work ceased when peace was declared in 1815 and left unfinished. The bastion was completed when there was a renewal threat of war from continental Europe in 1867. This resulted in two bastions being linked together, known as the North Centre Bastion and the Detached Bastion. It is rumoured that prisoners were kept at the Detached Bastion before being transferred onto what was known as prison hulks. Prison hulks were floating prison ships that had their internal structure reconfigured, including jail cells, in order to accommodate convicted criminals or occasionally prisoners of war. In 2016, more than 200 human remains were found offshore. Men and young boys who died from disease on board these prison hulks 200 years ago. Originally buried in wooden coffins and then thrown overboard, they laid under 6 feet of mud, but coastal erosion and rising sea levels then washed away the mud to expose the remains. We have located several photographs taken by visitors to Dead Man's Island, supporting claims of the paranormal activity that takes place here. White mist that has the shape of a skeleton. orbs of light that move in the corridors and tunnels. And shadow figures that hide within its walls. On our previous investigation here, we encountered the paranormal activity that stays within this location.
How many of you are here?
Does anybody want to let me know what it was like to work here? You all right, Jeff?
Who's that? But we would be interested in talking to you.
With our equipment set up and all in place, it was time to commence the return to Dead Man's Island.
So here we are for our second investigation at Dead Man's Island. I've got Phil here and Clive, and before we could set up our equipment, as we were walking through, we actually saw a shadow figure. We heard banging noises, and on our way through here, we can only describe as a metal noise sound right behind us. So we've all heard and seen that. So we're starting off here in this area, and this is where last time I heard a voice directly in my ear. There was some movement inside this room. So if you can hear me, can you join us in this room, please? Come and join us, please. Come and speak to me again like you did last time. Don't be worried about the equipment and devices that we got. Just helps us know that you're here. Is the captain here, please? They say that they see you here. Hello, Captain. Can you come and speak to us, please? Now, last time on our investigation here, we caught many voices. In fact, our motion detectors were triggered. Now, there's one here in the doorway, and there's another one just outside the doorway there, and there's a device in the doorway, which is called a REM pod, which will pick up on your magnetic field if you come anywhere into this room. Can you come into this room, please? The prisoners that were kept here were transferred onto prison hulks, big prison ships. But unfortunately, there was a lots of disease back in them days. And your bodies were put in small wooden coffins and thrown overboard. And only today are those remains coming to the surface. Hundreds and hundreds of you. So if you're one of the prisoners, please come and talk to us. Come and tell us your story.
Our first EVP is captured. I ask for one of the prisoners to come forward and tell us their story, and the reply is maybe. Here is the audio with enhancements.
I just realised. Last time, this is where we heard the walking at the bottom. Someone was walking around. Hello? Is there anybody there? Can you hear my voice? Can you make some sort of noise or movement? Can you walk towards me? Come and walk towards me, please.
Carry on making our way through this part of the tunnel section, but where we have our static night vision camera placed, our motion detector is activated within the doorway as it picks up movement nearby.
Is anyone down there? I'm taking some pictures with this device that's called a camera. And if you come and stand in front of it, we can take your picture. So can you come and show yourself in front of this camera? Can you tell us what your name is, please? How long have you been here?
Whoa. Something just moved right across between you and me.
Ooh.
Literally between the two of us.
Wow.
It was big.
Did Phil just see you? Are you a prisoner?
Jeez. What was that? It's alright, it's a pigeon, I think.
Way outside.
It's here, it's in here, it's flying between you and me.
What, a pigeon? You would hear it?
Well, it looked like a pigeon.
Phil thinks he sees a pigeon, but when we review our camera's footage, it turns out to be a bat. It is also filmed on our static cam as it flies towards our location within the tunnels. We review our full spectrum photos that were taken within the tunnel system. Out of the 30 that were taken, all were normal, apart from two that shows anomalies. We leave this part of the fault and make our way to the other sections.
We've returned back here to come and talk to you again. Can you come and join us so we can find out more about why you stay here? Now, earlier on, we saw what looked like somebody walking across in front of us. And then as we progressed through the tunnels, we heard noises behind us. So if you're following us, you're obviously interested in what we're doing. Now, we're here not only to find out more about the history of this place, but also to hear your story. So take this opportunity, come and stand with us and talk to us about your experiences and, as I've already said, why you stay here. Let us know you're here. You have no reason to fear us or be scared. The equipment which we're holding is purely to document what we find. So if you come here, the device I'm holding will record your voice. There's a little red light. If you talk into the red light as loud as you can, even if we can't hear you now, we'll be able to listen to you later. What's your name? If you're a soldier, I'm asking you to give me your name, your rank, and your number, and you need to do that.
A voice responds to Phil's request, but we are unable to decipher what is being said. Here is the audio enhanced.
If you're a soldier, I'm asking you to give me your name, your rank, and your number, and you need to do that. If you're a soldier, I'm asking you to give me your name, your rank, and your number, and you need to do that.
We set up our laser grid covering the length of the corridor with a night vision cam and a normal HD cam side by side to see if we can detect any movement.
Okay, we're back in this tunnel again that Phil's in earlier, and at the bottom we've set up a laser grid. It's nothing to worry about. All it will do is the cameras will pick you up more easily if you break the beams, and we'll be able to see you moving in any direction. And I'm just wondering if you was a local, did you live local to where this fort is? Did you live in Dover? Did you live further away, perhaps in London? When you was stationed here during the war, was your family allowed to come with you? Perhaps they stayed in accommodation either here in the fort, or did the army find them accommodation in the town perhaps? Now, as my colleague mentioned earlier, my name's Clive. Maybe you could introduce yourself to me. You can speak into this digital recorder, and there's an extra sensitive one here that you can speak into. So you can just whisper your name and that will pick you up really quite well.
Something's moving down at the end there, but it's behind the laser grid and the static cam. Something's moving down at the end there. Hey, Clive.
Yes?
It's like it's watching us from behind our equipment. It's standing behind the static cam and the laser grid. It knows that if it comes up here, we're going to see it. But if it stays behind our equipment, it can, whoever it is can just watch us from there.
You're getting that feeling as well?
It's like someone standing behind there watching us.
Another EVP is captured, saying they know we're here, confirming that we are being watched from the other end of the tunnel. Here is the enhanced audio.
But if it stays behind our equipment, it can, whoever it is can just watch us from there.
You're getting that feeling as well?
It's like someone standing behind there watching us.
They know we're here.
It's like someone standing behind there watching us.
They know we're here.
Is there anybody down there behind the camera who wants to make themselves known?
Are you watching us from behind our cameras? You've drained the power from our laser grid. They were brand new batteries. That laser grid's only been on for a few minutes. Perhaps you're watching us, trying to find out what we're doing here. But we've come here to speak to you. Can you shout out your name, please? Tell me your name, please. Shout out as loud as you can. What is your name? Hello there. My name's Jeff. What's yours? How long have you been watching us for? You're probably wondering what we're doing down here. We've only come to speak to you. To learn more about the history of this place. Was you a prisoner? Or did you actually work here? Was you one of the soldiers? Can we see you, please? You've got nothing to worry about. Just come walking down here, and then we'll be able to see you. Come and join us. We're quite friendly. What the? What the f-
As I stand in the corridor and ask whatever is there to join us, I see something black rush towards me at great speed, breaking through the laser grid. At this moment, I am thinking that I'm going to be attacked, but it suddenly disappears. On reviewing our cameras, we find that this was not paranormal at all, but another bat. It flies towards me, loops the loop in front of my face, and then flies back down the corridor.
Did you used to work here? Was you a soldier? Was you a prisoner? Come through on the white noise. Why do you stay here? My name's Jeff. This is Clive. The man with the camera is Phil. What's your name? My name's Jeff. This is Clive. The man with the camera is Phil. What's your name? My name's Jeff. This is Clive. The man with the camera is Phil. What's your name?
No more voices came through the spirit box, and the location fell silent, so we packed up our equipment and made our way out of Dead Man's Island.